Where did all the antimatter go? My name is Igor Bray. I'm Professor of Physics at Curtin University and Head of Department of Physics and Astronomy. The standard model of physics predicts that at the Big Bang, both matter and antimatter would have been created in equal amounts. But if we look around us, there's lots and lots of matter, and there is very, very little antimatter. Yet the little antimatter we have is very, very useful. We use the fact that matter and antimatter annihilate to detect cancer. PET scans, PET stands for positron emission tomography, is used for cancer detection. So there are many very useful aspects of antimatter, but no one understands why there is so little of it. Another problem that we have is that we do not have unification of general relativity or gravity and quantum mechanics. This is a particularly interesting problem because small particles are governed by the laws of quantum mechanics, including antimatter. The question is, how would antimatter behave under gravity? Right now, at CERN in Europe, there are several experimental collaborations whose goal is to make as many anti-hydrogen atoms as possible to perform gravitational experiments. Create a beam of anti-hydrogen atoms, let it drop, and see what happens. Does it go down like ordinary hydrogen? Does it stay still and not affected by gravity? Or does it rise in terms of anti-gravity? Nobody knows what will happen. Our job at Curtin is to provide calculations for the experimental groups that will help them to maximize the number of anti-hydrogen atoms made. What these experiments are about is to try and understand why there is difference between antimatter and matter in our current universe. Well, whoever works this out will win a Nobel Prize in physics.